Hey everyone, today, welcome to today's episode of, Cooking Wif Joseph, with me, Joseph. I was at the store today, at my local Smith's, and I thought, man, it would be really nice to cook something today, cause I eat out all the time, and, man, can't do that shit all the time. I gotta cook. So today, I went to Smith's, and I saw something that I just could not pass up. What I have today is I got Mishima Reserve Luxury Wagyu Beef with extraordinary taste and tenderness. Now, what you're gonna wanna do for this is you're gonna wanna get your big old pan pot thing and just slap it right on there. Put it down. There you go. Now, you're gonna wanna cut this bitch up to get the beef in the beef. Oh man, look at that beef. Alright, that's looking pretty good. Now, I'm gonna start with something simple. We're just gonna put it in the pan. So, now, this is my favorite part, because you get to get the beef out of the package. Now, I don't know how this Wagyu cooks. I usually cook with lean beef. I don't know how lean this Wagyu is. I don't like no oil in my beef. But this is supposed to be high quality beef. I went to the store, it cost a whole dollar more than all the other beef. So, obviously, it's gotta be good. It says it has good taste. And that it's, Wagyu. Ugh. Alright. As you can see, I got most of the beef out of the package. But most is not enough. This package says it's exactly 1 pound. And this recipe calls for 1 pound. So I'm gonna wanna get... You're gonna wanna get all the beef out of this bad boy. Get all of it. Ooh. And you can already hear that sizzling over the smooth jazz. Ooh, just... Ooh. Alright, that looks like it's all the beef, boys. Now that we got that cooking, it's time to wash your hand from all the beef. Man. Just look at that. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, ooh, that's pretty good. Now, I'm gonna wanna use a strained spatula, one of the, it's got the holes in it. Yeah, look at that bad boy. And I'll explain later why I wanna use that spatula. Now, you don't wanna just use any spatula for this goddamn Wagyu. You wanna use this spatula. You just want to get on in there. Now the key to cooking this beef, it's already ground, but you still want to just do a bit of this. Just break it up. You gotta break it all up. You gotta get it. It's still ground, but now it's time to get it brown. Ha! All right, this is looking pretty good. Now you may be wondering, man, what is he gonna do with all this beef? And I'll tell you, after it's brown. Ooh. Man, can you just... Alright, it looks like it's got some oil to it. This don't look like no lean beef. This is that Wagyu shit. Damn, son. Ooh. Just... cooking that shit up. Oh, look at it go.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ooh. Ah. Now, if you're following along at home, you're gonna realize that, man, this smells pretty good. It smells like some nice Wagyu. And that's probably because it is. I got beef on my phone. I also got my beef at home. Now, this is looking, it's starting to get a bit brown. It's still gonna take a bit longer to get to brown town. So let's get on over here and we're gonna get a big old strainer. That's right. We don't want no beef fat all up in our shit, all up in our fucking veins. Hell no, we're gonna strain that shit. Now, ooh, look at that. Perfect size. We're gonna get all of this Wagyu beef oil out of the Wagyu. Fuck. Fuck. Hold on. Alright. You know, I always like to listen to smooth jazz while I'm cooking. It really, really calms me down. It gets me so peaceful. Cooking is a real art. You gotta appreciate that shit. You gotta, man, you really just gotta do it and just go at it. You know, I used to cook a lot of the time, and now I cook almost none of the time. But, you know, new year, new me. I wanna change, you know? I wanna cook shit again. Shit's fun. Oh, it smells so good. Ugh, smell that Wagyu. Ooh. Now, if you can see, the lighting's a bit weird. We're still seeing some pink. This ain't ready yet. So you're gonna wanna break that shit up, ground it up, get it all mixed up until there ain't a speck of pink up in this bitch, alright? Yeah. Ooh. And now usually I cook the lean beef. But this shit's got oil, but that actually helps with the cooking a bit. You see, with lean beef, if you're gonna be browning it and you want a nice even brown, you just slap some water in there. Just put some water in, put a lid on, and it steams it, and it cooks it a lot faster. But see, because this got the oil already, you get a lot better heat distribution. That heat's just getting all up in this meat. Ooh. Just look at that beef. Now, in real life, my lighting's fucking terrible. I can barely even see this beef. It all looks brown to me. But on my phone, I still see pink. And that's no good. Shit stink. Like beef. Ooh, just listen to that nice beef cooking. Here, I wanna see the beef. There we go. Ooh. Ooh, look at that. Oh, man. Once it focuses, it'll look real good. Nah. Is that brown beef? Nah, yeah, I still see some pink. Just taking like 10 minutes. I thought this would be like a quick bit, but nah, I'm still browning beef. Don't worry about it. It looks good. And the nice thing is, this isn't just beef. I'm not a beef boy. I'm not just eating beef for dinner. I'm gonna add shit to it. When you add that shit to it, it just cooks the beef even further. So even though this may not be 100% brown right now, I'm gonna call it good, because it'll still get brown later. Now you're gonna wanna turn off the heat, because it's time to drain the beef. Alright. Now you're going to want to be real careful with this. You're going to want to use two hands. I'm using one hand because I'm a professional. But you guys out there doing this along at home, you're going to want to do it with two hands. Now, I don't know what's in this mug, but you know what's going to be in this mug? Beef fat. I don't usually pour the beef fat down the drain. You know why? Because my plumbing is shit, so apparently that's bad for the... We got, we don't even have a sewer system. We got, yeah, we don't even got a sewer system, so... Fucking... Apparently, for the... I don't know what it's called. But for the thing that we do have, all this beef fat apparently would be real bad for it. But see, I don't want nothing bad all up in there. I want it in this mug. Now you don't want to strain all of the beef. Usually I'd get in there with like a spatula and really squeeze it out. Squeeze out all that fat. But I'm not gonna do that because I have one hand right now. But you can still see, man, that's a lot of beef fat, dude. That's a lot of oil. And you don't want none of that oil while you're cooking, because that shit just tastes bad. It gets your mouth all oily. It's no good. It's no fun. I don't like it. I hate it, man. Fuck that shit. Alright. Now that we got this beef all strained, now this is going to be a Joe Pro tip right here. None of you guys have ever seen this before on a cooking show or otherwise. You guys probably don't even know this shit exists. Look right here. I'm gonna get one basic paper towel, alright? I'm gonna get one basic paper towel. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sop up the rest of this fat. You see, you just get in there and you just clean it. You don't get that much beef on the paper towel, but you get the fat on the paper towel. So that's just making it even drier, because this shit is gonna have a sauce. You can't have no fucking Wagyu tasting like oil. Hell no, dude. You want a nice sauce, which is gonna be our next step. But first, you just get all up in there. You get all that extra fat, and you get rid of all that. Look at that. You can barely even see it, because it won't focus. And also, because it's like transparent because of all the fucking fat you just got. You're gonna get another one. That's right, I'm not done yet. I wanna get more of this fat out of here. See, cause this is where we poured the fat out of, and so that's where all the fat collected and not all of it poured out. It was still dripping when I stopped. But now, it's not. All right, now that we got all that beef fat out of there, it's time for our next step. We're gonna make a nice sauce for this shit. That's right, we're making a sauce for this Wagyu beef. Now, it will be perfect on its own. I could eat this shit right now, but I'm not gonna. I'm gonna make it better. All right, here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna go to your pantry. Now, I didn't do no mise en place. I didn't get my ingredients out beforehand to make this easier, because I was just so excited to cook this Wagyu, man. What could I do? Oh, do I want to do a nice coconut milk Wagyu? Ooh, I could make like an Asian fusion thing. I could throw in some Campbell's Tuscan style lentil. Or we could do the real beef meal. This, none of that. What you came for is this. The motherfucking hamburger helper. Cheesy Italian shells. Ooh, that's right. Bet you weren't expecting a gourmet motherfucker up in here. You were probably just expecting a burger. A fucking burger. Hell nah, dude. We're making... not that. We're making this. Look at that. We already got step one down and you didn't even know it. Now, we're gonna stir with all these fucking ingredients. We got the lean ground beef. Well, it wasn't lean, it was Wagyu. We got the 1¾ cup hot water.
Watch this shit. This is my super secret trick. This is, a quarter. And this is a full cup. And you know what that make? You measure it a couple times, and you get the 1¾ cup hot water.
Now we're gonna let this run for a bit. I don't have an instant hot water heater. It takes time. And while we're doing that, we're gonna get the milk. This big boy right here. Damn, son. That's milk. All right. You're gonna wanna pour yourself a nice big cup of milk. Ooh, look at that. You can see it. It's starting to build over the side. It's got like, that is a cup of milk. And I'm gonna spill it now. Man, it's so fun cooking with you guys. We got jazz in the background. Too much milk, some nice running water. We used to have the sizzle of that beef. Let me put this milk shit down. We gotta turn the heat back on. We're still cooking. Once I got that milk in. Woo. Now at home, you could probably do this in a couple steps. In fact, at home, you could just use two hands and bring the pot to the milk. Oh, not a drop spilt. And now, we're just gonna get some water. Ooh, look at that. Nice and steamy. Hot water. Ooh. Got some bubbles in it. Nice. And that's gonna cook the beef. And now we got, we got three of these. That's right. One. Dose. Veinte, we're in there. And now for the milk. Ooh. Ooh. We getting some motherfucking milk. Alright. If you're counting along at home, this is 1½ cups of milk. But you know, I don't use none of those half cups. That shit takes way too much water to clean. And you know me, I'm a clean boy. I don't waste, waste not, want not. That's what they always used to say. Now, we're gonna turn this off, and we're gonna turn this on. We're gonna get some pasta in here. That's right. Pasta time, baby. Just like Mima used to make. She used to make hamburger helper. She's a lazy bitch. Alright. Now, you're gonna wanna make sure not to miss any of these shells. We got a limited supply. I don't just got shells at home. It comes in the hamburger helper box. I can't just buy that at a store. Hell nah. We gotta get it out of the bag. Fresh, never frozen pasta. You see all these little bits? We're gonna get all those little bits too. I'm a hungry, growing boy. I need all the pasta I can get in my body right now. And see, I can't do that thing with a powder packet. Hell nah, that shit would blow up all up in my face. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna go find some scissors. Parents are always moving the scissors. That's me right now. All right. Well, this is my dad's office. No scissors. You're gonna want to make sure to do this fast. Probably get, you know, if you're following one along at home, you should probably already have the scissors. You should have known that. Who cooks hamburger helper with no scissors? That's just stupid. But I can't find them, so it looks like the next best thing. Knife number two. Oh, and that is just cutting beautifully. Look at that. Ooh, look at that. Nice sauce powder. We're gonna pour that out of that little hole that, no. Need to cut some more. All right. Okay, that's, ooh, look. Now we got a real hole. And that will just pour right in. See, it's working. I'm a professional. Now, if you're doing this with me at home, don't do it like this. You don't want to pour it into those pasta shells, because you know what happens? If you don't stir those pasta shells good enough, the powder, it just builds up in all of those pasta shells, and then you just bite into a pasta sauce-filled shell, and it's super gross, and it's nasty, and it's all, like, soggy, but then the bit at the back, it's all dry, because, you know, that sauce, it, like, the part on the outside, it gets all damp, and then it just doesn't get the other bit damp, because, like, the milk doesn't get in, and the water doesn't, the Wagyu oil can't get in, because it's in the sink. Now, we almost have all of the sauce out. We almost... Motherfucker. Alright, then you're gonna want to put down your phone and open the sauce packet all the way, like a real person do. Now, you can't see this right now, but I'm actually pouring the sauce in with both hands. And if you're watching this at home, why don't you put down your phone and use both hands like a grown man too, because then you get all of that sauce powder out. Ooh, I opened up. Now, you're not seeing this right now, but I'm taking the sauce packet to the trash. Ooh, and it's gone. And now I'm washing my hands to get the sauce. Oh, that's gone too. And that could be you if you're cooking at home with Joseph. And we're back. Cooking with Joseph. Now, look at this shit. Look at that. Look at that shell. It's what I was telling you about. That shell's gonna be nasty later. But still, if you stir it good enough, you might luck out and not get a nasty-ass pasta shell. And see, look at this instruction manual. You wanna stir it, heat it to boiling. This bitch ain't boiling. But once it is, you're gonna simmer it and cook it for 25 minutes and see what I do. I throw away my trash. But I also check back in every 7 minutes to stir this bitch up again. Because, see, you don't want it to simmer too long. Then it'll overboil, it gets too hot. Some parts might get burnt. You don't want to do that? Hell no. You want to stir it and be a responsible adult. And turn up that heat so it boils faster. What you want to do? Take this nasty-ass mug out of the sink and put it not there. Put it over there. So that when you're rinsing out, you don't get the oil in the sink. Because that's what my parents told me. And what about this milk? Bish, you left out the milk. Hell no, we're gonna clean this shit right up. Because now we have time. Ooh. And you never seen a counter so clean. It's, ooh, so good. And what's that? Ooh. Jump cut back over to here. Look at that shit. It's almost boiling now. I'd say that's a low bubble. It's almost like it's simmering, but simmering is step three. Right now, it's boiling. Almost. We're almost done with step two.
Now you're going to want to take all these little bits, and you're going to want to... No, don't put it in. But you are going to want to put it in the trash. Damn, son. Oof. And you're going to want to take this and put it in the trash. And then you're going to want to take this big old nasty bitch. And you're going to want to put it in the recycling. Like an adult. Oh, and look at that! Shit's already boiling. Now you're going to want to turn it down to a simmer. Timer. I'm actually setting the timer on my phone, but if you had, a microwave, you could set the timer, and then it would go off when the time is done. But first, we're gonna put away the milk. Oh, that's right, you thought I forgot. You thought this milk was gonna go bad? Hell no, I'm gonna drink it later with my Reese's Puffs! Oh! And for our next secret ingredient, Jardine's Ghost Pumpkin Salsa. That's gonna be on next week's Cooking with Joseph, if I remember to do that. Oh, this bitch ain't simmering, it's boiling. Turn that heat down, motherfucker. We don't want this shit overcooking. The beef is already cooked. I don't want it to cook more. That's just well done. And well done is no fun. But I would say that's pretty mixed. I mean, look at that. It don't look white no more like that. Milk. Alright. This is gonna be the last step that I'm gonna show you guys, because the rest of this time, I'm just gonna be sitting here waiting 25 minutes for my food to actually be done cooking. Your next step, get down in this bitch, get the lid. And you don't want to put the lid on, you don't want to put it on like this. Hell nah, because then all the heat's gonna build up, and it's gonna get burnt. No, you want to put it like off to the side, so it still keeps in some of that heat. You're not letting it all escape. But see, some of it is escaping. So it just keeps up bubbling like this. It's not gonna boil over. It's not gonna go fucking crazy. I do this shit all the time. It works. Now, I'm gonna sit here and listen to my smooth jazz while I wait for my dinner to cook. I'm also gonna do an after picture probably. So you probably, I mean, you already saw that before you watched to this point in the video, but that's what this is. It's when it's done. Cause I'm not gonna sit here for 25 minutes so you can watch this cooking, because I only have 23 minutes left of video space on my phone. So that's a no bueno. So I'm going to see you guys next week on Cooking with Joseph. Don't die.